So hi, hello and welcome again, Microbehunter here. Well, did you actually know that there are no less than 327 billion cells in a Christmas tree? Well, I didn't know that myself until I figured it out, and today in this video I want to share with you the method that I use to determine this number of cells. And a little bit of background information first. Every time during Christmas, I usually put something under the microscope that's a little bit related with Christmas. So in the previous years, I usually put some of those fir needles under the microscope. This year, I decided to increase the level of difficulty a little bit more. And I said I wanted to determine the number of cells that can be found in my Christmas tree. Because a couple of days ago, when I bought the Christmas tree, I found that it was quite heavy to carry, and I basically thought to myself, well, there are probably going to be a lot of cells in this Christmas tree that make the tree so heavy. And indeed, yeah, they are. And so for this reason, I decided to do a little bit of microscopic observation to find out the number of cells. However, that's actually not quite as easy sometimes, because in order to determine the number of cells, we have to divide the mass of the Christmas tree by the mass of one individual cell. And I think I don't have to tell you that it's impossible to determine the mass of one cell, because there is no scale that is that precise so that you're actually able to measure the mass of individual cells here. And counting the cells, well, that's of course out of the question. It would take me over 10,000 years to count all of the cells. That would be a little bit boring, and I honestly have better things to do basically I were to count one cell per second. That is certainly not a feasible option. How do you, however, determine the mass of one cell? And there is an indirect way that I would like to share with you today. So let's start off with the easy things first. I first determined the mass of the tree, which was 17.1 kilograms. Easy to do. I simply lifted the tree onto a scale. But now I need to determine the density of the tree. And I need the density because over the density, I'm able to determine the mass of one cell. So it's this indirect way that allows me to solve this little riddle here. Now, how do you determine the density of the tree? Well, density is mass divided by volume. So I've taken a small branch and I put it also on a scale, and it's 2.79 grams. But now I need to determine the volume. How can you do that? Because the branch with all of its leaves and the wood and everything is very irregular. There is no easy way to actually calculate it. But what I've done is I used the so-called the water displacement method. So what I did is I submerged the branch in a cylinder, in a graduated cylinder with water. And I watched how far the water level actually goes up. And the level in the increase in the volume of the water is the amount, is the volume of the branch. So, and I determined this to be 3.5 milliliters. So I've got the 2.79 grams in 3.5 milliliters gives me a density of 0.8 grams per milliliter. And we do a few unit conversions now. That's 800 kilograms per cubic meter, and I have to use kilograms and meters because otherwise I'm not able to do the math properly. So I got the density now, okay? I got the mass of the tree, I got the density of the tree, and now finally I can do a little bit of microscopy now, and now finally I can determine the mass of one cell, and I have to first measure out the volume of the cell. Now, finally, I can use my microscope, and what I've done is I made very thin cross sections of the needles of the fir tree, about 10 to 15 cross sections using a very sharp razor blade. And I put them under the microscope, and essentially I was able to see the individual cells, which kind of shows that the cross sections were sufficiently thin. I was also able to see the chloroplasts, of course. These are the green cell organelles that are responsible for photosynthesis, so even that worked out. So I was quite happy with the result, and I looked around, and I found one cell that I decided to use as, so to say, the standard cell for all further calculations. And now, how do you measure the diameter of the cell? Well, I used a so-called micrometer slide. This is a special slide that contains engraved a very, very fine small scale. And the distance between two of these lines is 10 micrometers. It's 10 millionths of a meter. And I took an image, a picture of this scale, and I superimposed it on a picture from the cell. Everything, of course, without changing any magnification. And I was able to determine the diameter of the cell to be approximately 50 micrometers across. And if the diameter is 50 micrometers, then I know the radius is 25 micrometers. And with the radius, I am now able to determine the volume of the cell, and I just assume that the cell is not a perfect sphere, a ball, so to say. I plugged it in, and indeed, I got a number here. I have to read it off. The volume of the cell is 6.54 times 10 to the power of negative 14 cubic meters. This is incredibly small, of course. But this volume is now very useful, because if I multiply the volume by the density, remember the 800 kilograms per cubic meter, then I'm getting the mass of the cell. That's really nice. And I determined this mass of the cell to be 5.22 times 10 to the power of negative 11 kilograms. I cannot imagine those numbers, they are so small. Yeah, but at least I now have the values that allows me to pull everything together. The 17.1 kilograms divided by the mass of a cell, the 5.22 times 10 to the power of negative 11 kilograms, gives me now the final answer. Drum roll, here it is. The number of cells in the Christmas tree is 327,922,745,017 cells. Here's the answer. Yeah, quite straightforward. Over 300 billion cells in this Christmas tree. What's 300 billion even? I mean, even that is a huge number. As a matter of fact, the number of stars in our Milky Way galaxy is about estimated to be about 100 billion cells. So this means that there are about three times as many cells in the Christmas tree as there are stars in our Milky Way galaxy. That's a nice little comparison. And how does this compare actually to the human body? How many cells are in the human body? Well, the number of cells in the human body is estimated to be approximately 30 trillion cells. Trillion with a T, and this means that a human body has approximately 100 times as many cells as the Christmas tree. That's possible because humans are generally a little bit heavier than those Christmas trees, and many of the cells that we have are actually also significantly smaller. So you see how we humans and the Christmas tree and the galaxy, how they actually are in relation here. I know this was a little unusual or unique little project, but I still hope that we all, including myself, of course, learn something from this. Of course, I understand that we're interested more in the order of magnitude here, not in the exact number. So there are lots of inaccuracies in the whole process. The cells have a different size, of course. The density measurement was not quite precise either. I just estimated it to be 3.5 milliliters. You get the idea, right? It doesn't really matter. We're interested just in an order of magnitude here. And of course, different size trees have different number of cells as well. Yeah, I think it still was very interesting to determine the number of cells this way. I hope that you also liked the video. There is a comments section below, and I would like to invite you, of course, to post your own comments here. Maybe you have your own take on this whole situation here, on this whole method. I wish you all the best. Happy microbe hunting, as always. See you around next time. Bye-bye.